Today, we are honoring two individuals. The first person that we're honoring is Aumua Amata from American Samoa. And I'm reading from the Board of Regents resolution. Whereas Congresswoman Aumua Amata is the daughter of the late Governor and Mrs. Peter Tali Coleman, and is married to Fred Bradawagon, with whom they have three grown children and two grandchildren. And whereas Congresswoman Aumua Amata Coleman Bradawagon received a Bachelor of Arts degree in psychology from the University of Guam, with additional studies at Loyola Marymount and George Mason Universities. And whereas Congresswoman Bradawagon was the first woman to be elected to the U.S. House of Representatives from American Samoa, and has been the most senior member of the Republican National Committee since 2012, and holds the title Orator, Talking Chief of Aumua from the village of Pangopango in American Samoa. And whereas Congresswoman Bradawagon was appointed by President George Bush as a White House Commissioner for Asian Americans and Pacific Islanders, and whereas Congresswoman Bradawagon is a member of the U.S. House of Representatives Majority Leadership Staff for 8 years, also served as Conference Scheduling Director, and supervised the database to reach out to Asian Pacific and other minority aspirants for congressional positions. And whereas Congresswoman Bradawagon, as a member of the Republican National Committee, served on the Chairman's Executive Council, the Committee on Arrangements, for 6 Republican National Conventions, served twice as an officer of the convention, and was a member of the Convention Rules Committee on Rules 6 times. Now, in all of that, you can take your pick on which one you want to celebrate. You can celebrate the fact that she's a leading member of the National Republican Party, but I choose to celebrate that she's a graduate of the University of Guam.
Thank you, President Underwood. Thank you to this great university, to its president, Dr. Robert Underwood, and all the alumni, faculty, and students who make this place so special, as well as the wonderful people of Guam. Education was always a priority in my family, especially with the example and encouragement of my father, Governor Coleman. Even so, when I earned a degree at the University of Guam in 1975, I never dreamed I'd be receiving another in this way from my alma mater. It's very humbling and a meaningful moment to be a small part of the legacy of this institution. I can't help but notice that this announcement is during Asian Pacific American Heritage Month. I've seen great progress for those of us who share the heritage from around the Pacific, and it's a pleasure to see new leaders and young leaders of the future representing our various cultures so well and taking on positions of responsibility and innovation in their communities, businesses, governments, not only within the United States, but also places like New Zealand and Australia. The University of Guam is the premier higher education institution for a large part of the immense Pacific region, and you have a special part in sending out leaders, educators, and entrepreneurs that can in the most powerful city in the world and seek to make a difference in lives, sometimes one life at a time, through casework for a military veteran, and sometimes pressing for a change that takes time, persuasion, and persistence. As insular representatives, we've learned that working together, we can accomplish much more for the territories than any one member can alone. I also have the immense blessing to regularly leave Washington and live the island life that I love in our home at Coconut Point. I could not ask for a better life, and the path that I walked in some ways started right here with my time on the beautiful island of Guam and my studies right here at the university. I could not have predicted then all that God had for me. Looking back, I'm immensely thankful, and I believe I still have much work to do. My prayer, like the psalmist, is that God would establish the work of my hands so that our voices, the people of American Samoa and other island territories, are heard in the halls of Congress. As a woman from a culture that has not traditionally elevated women to leadership, my story is one of persistence. Every time I stand before the next generation, I'm filled with optimism. The future is bright, and I know you will come and work together and do wonderful things in the years ahead. I humbly encourage you to persist. Persist, and doors will open before that you never anticipated. Thank you once again. God bless the people of Guam and the United States of America. Jesus.